Hello, Nasdaq followers, and welcome to another episode of Behind the Bell. I'm your host, Leanne Alfaro, and we're coming to you from Times Square, New York City, where we're joined by EXP right here as we get set to ring the closing bell. Joining me right now is Glen Sanford, founder and CEO, as well as RJ Jones, who's EVP of Finance. Thank you so much for joining us.
Awesome. Thanks for having us.
Yes, thank you.
So, Glen, start by telling us a little bit about the mission and vision here.
Yeah, so EXP World Holdings is the holding company for EXP Realty, and we're a cloud-based residential real estate brokerage. We're actually the first real estate brokerage to operate in all 50 states. We're non-traditional in that we don't actually have physical offices for our agents to go to, which was sort of what happened in the 90s and, you know, early 2000s. That's where all the agents went. But with technology, we're able to sort of free agents from having to go to a physical office, and because consumers are searching online, we can create a new model of brokerage. So as a result, we started in 2009 with about 25 agents. Actually, today, we're up almost 1,000 agents just this month to 26,000 and change. And it's just been a rocket ride because we've kind of rewrote the compensation model for real estate professionals, because we've been able to take that cost and then pass that on to them as extra benefits in the model of real estate, and then that helps them be a better agent in the field.
Incredible. And now talk to us about the landscape that you're in.
Yeah, it's a huge business. Residential real estate, you know, 5-6 million homes a year change hands every year, and there's over 1.2 million licensees, or actually members of the National Association of Realtors. So there's a lot of members that are in this space selling real estate. You know, $60-70 billion a year in commissions that are generated from those sales, and there hasn't really been a new model from the agent perspective in many years, ever since the day of the broker owner setting up shop and inviting agents to come into their office. There wasn't something that really empowered the agent in a way that our model does. So the backdrop is really, you know, a lot of brokerages aren't really growing. We see some that are public that, you know, are really stagnant in their value proposition. And then you've got other companies like ours who are kind of disrupting that sort of model a bit. And so we're very attractive to a large number of the agents to come and join.
So it certainly seems like you're at the forefront of what's next for this particular business. And here at Nasdaq, we're definitely in the business of rewriting the industries and rewriting the markets. So what are some projects that you're interested in or excited about that are coming up for EXP?
So RJ, I don't know if you...
I have a number of them. There are two in particular. One is focused on real estate agents and how to help them do more, how to help them do more sales. So that can be through any number of means that would be beyond what they normally would do in their own business. So our platform is about enabling their success. So finding partnerships, finding new ways to drive customer acquisition. That's one particular project I'm working on. The other is expanding our value proposition across different aspects of the real estate industry. I can't get into the particulars about it, but if you think of the different industries that are involved in real estate, not only residential, but other forms, so whether it's mortgage, title, et cetera, and so on, it's looking at different aspects of the industry and then going further than we've ever before in other categories.
Incredible. And Glen, do you have anything to add there?
You know, well, one thing that, you know, makes us pretty unique is the way that we actually operate. So we actually operate our entire company inside a virtual world for business. So we actually show up as avatars, and that actually creates the ability for us to be cloud-based. But then it also potentially powers some of these other verticals that we're sort of looking at, of how could we maybe be somewhat disruptive in other spaces that can be sort of either right alongside the residential real estate agent and sort of cross-pollinate them, or be other unique verticals. We actually bought the platform Verbella. It's actually a platform that was developed at a University of San Diego, University of California, San Diego, over the last 5-6 years. We bought them last year. And we're pretty excited about what other things we're going to be able to do with that. Of course, we're doing things in the iBuyer space, which is kind of something that makes a lot of news right now in the industry. We've got a platform called Express Offers, operates in 14 states already. But we've got other things coming down the pipe that we're pretty stoked about.
It's pretty incredible. And now, looking at the industry for the last few years that you have been in, what are some of the biggest changes that you've seen? Obviously, moving into technology and cloud-based is a huge shift, and a good one at that. But what are some of the other kind of evolutions you've seen?
Well, there's been two that I would point to as more interesting. One is the movement from a way the traditional industry had worked to more being consumer-focused or consumer-empowered around data that's available to consumers that has proliferated through different value propositions over the internet. The other is capital coming into the industry as a whole and creating more motivation for innovation. So new companies coming in that are trying different ways at actually moving through transactions, or new brokerage value propositions that are now making their way through the industry in a way that they hadn't before and finding some traction and some success. So from our perspective, it's, again, looking at our platform, how can we enable agents to be thriving through that environment and also be on the forefront of innovation? So one of the things that Glen mentioned, there is a number of companies that are participating in that iBuyer space. How can we help agents find success, and how can we help clients find success in navigating the different value propositions that are out there? We really feel that our platform enables our agents to provide the best solution set to their clients in any type of value or offering that can come their way.
And looking to the future, what most excites you about what's coming up there?
From my perspective, it's actually how early on we are as a company in the runway of growth that's ahead of us. We currently have a very actually small set of agents in relation to the number of agents that are out there, or if you look at the number of transactions that are coming through our system, we have a fraction of what is possible or potential for us in terms of what our growth and our market presence can be. So over the course of the next couple of years, as Glen had mentioned, what is being noticed now in our system is how this value proposition for agents and how they can be successful, thrive on our platform, be innovative, grow their business, and have a very interesting and compelling compensation model. We're in our early stages of what we can be in terms of our potential and realizing that. So over the course of the next few years, we believe pretty strongly that our growth is really just beginning in a sense.
Yeah, and we've just also launched, we were now in Canada as of a few years ago. We're now in the UK, we're now in Australia. So we're also, this model is actually portable into other countries, and it's not expensive to do that relative to other traditional models. So we're excited about the potential of taking this around the world.
I mean, that sounds like you're already well on your way.
We are.
Well, fantastic. So exciting to hear your progress so far. Again, thank you so much for joining us. We are looking forward to ringing the closing bell with you in just a few minutes.
Awesome. Thanks,
thank
Leanne.
Thank you so much.
Nasdaq followers, please stay tuned for more coverage coming to you right here from the Nasdaq channel. Until then, we are signing off with EXP, about to ring the closing bell here at the Nasdaq.